Hi friends, this is Priya. Welcome to Fashion Extracts. If you're new here, please subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon so you don't miss any of our videos. This is the second video of embroidery series and today's topic is Kasuti of Karnataka. If you have missed the first video and want to know more about embroidery, the link is in the description box below. Please go and have a look. Now coming back to our topic, Kasuti is a traditional embroidery practiced on a cotton fabric by Lambani women in Dharwad district of Karnataka. Kasuti features folk designs influenced by Rangoli patterns of Karnataka. Kasuti embroidery is very intricate and sometimes involves putting up to 5,000 stitches by hand and is traditionally made on attires like ilkil sarees, kanjivaram sarees, blouses and kurtas. The history of Kasuti. The history of Kasuti dates back to Chalukya period. The word Kasuti is derived from the words kai means hand and suti means cotton. Hence Kasuti means handwork made on cotton fabric. Kasuti is an unique art from historical times, supposed to be a necessary craft to be learnt by women courtiers in the royal state of Mysore in the 17th century. In olden days, it was a custom that the bride had to possess a black silk sari called Chandrakali sari with kasuti work on it. A mirror work, gold and silver thread embroidery were used for special occasions like wedding. The stitches employed in kasuti are ganti or gavanti, murgi, neigi and menti. Ganti is a double running stitch, murgi is a zigzag stitch, neigi is a running stitch and menti is a cross stitch resembling fenugreeks. The motifs used in kasuti. Kasuti work involves embroidering very intricate patterns like gopuras, shivalinga, nandi, chariot, palanquin, lamps, conch shells, and apart from this, various types of creepers, flowers, leaves, animals and birds are taken as motifs. The colors used in kasuti: red, green, purple, orange and crimson. The brighter shade of these colors are being taken. The threads used in kasuti. Silk threads were used in olden days. Now instead of silk yarns, mercerized cotton threads are being used. 2 to 4 strands are used for fine work. This may vary according to the type of material, motif and stitches employed. The process of kasuti. Materials which are easily available in the market are used for kasuti. The patterns to be embroidered is first traced using a tracing paper or can be embroidered directly on a even weave fabrics. After deciding the motif, the proper needles and threads are being selected. The work is tough and involves counting of each thread on cloth. The patterns are stitched without using knots to make sure that both the sides of the fabric look similar. The Karnataka Handicrafts Development Corporation holds a geographical indications protection for kasuti embroidery, which provides intellectual property rights on kasuti to KHDC. A kasuti center was set up in Hubli by the Department of Social Welfare, Government of Karnataka, to encourage the kasuti culture and also to provide a single roof for rural women to showcase their craft. Kasuti is a beautiful embroidery and a very special craft, but suffering from poor patronage with not many people willing to take the craft seriously. That's it about today's video. Thank you for watching. Hope you have gained some knowledge about kasuti embroidery. If you like this video, please like, share, subscribe and click the bell icon. Stay tuned for upcoming videos. Until then, take care. Bye.